But the Blues, case at all. Not sick of Craig Berube.
No. Why would they?
Signing him to a 3-year contract to be the head coach of the St. Louis Blues. No more interim tag. No more of that nonsense. He'll be around for the next 3 years. And today, front office held a press conference officially introducing Craig Berube as their head coach.
We're here to announce Craig Berube's 3-year contract to be the head coach of the Blues. Obviously, what Craig did coming in last year and the way the season ended was spectacular for our city, for our organization, and he's earned every right to be the head coach here moving forward. And as Craig and I talked about, I hope it's the next 3 are just 3 of many.
I just want to thank Blues organization, obviously Doug Armstrong, for just giving me the opportunity to coach the St. Louis Blues. I think it's a challenge every year coming in the new season, but it'll be a little bit of a tougher challenge this year winning the Cup. Your season's a lot longer this year, so training is a little bit tougher. So coming into camp is going to be important that we push and be ready to go.
I mean, really, what else can we say? I don't think this is a surprise to anybody that he's going to be sticking around.
The only surprise is, what day is today? Like the 26th of June? Like what took so long?
Maybe?
Yeah. The 26th, I don't have any idea what day it is.
Yeah.
It is the 26th.
26th of June.
There you go.
I'll ask you guys this.
Yes.
And I've talked to you quite a bit about this, Ege, but Johnny, I haven't seen you in a while, so I'll get your take. Why do you think that Craig was able to have such an impact on that group of players at that time? Because he talked a lot when he first took over about needing to change the room. Why do you think he was the guy that was able to do it?
Because he had the force of personality and strength of resume as a player to command the attention. And I think the interim tag almost helped him in this case because he was of the mindset thinking, I see a problem, I'm going to try to fix it my way. And if it doesn't work, I'm the interim guy, I'm not going to be here anyways. They're going to bring another guy in, he's going to hire another assistant coach, and I'm not going to be around. And so Craig Berube could walk into that team and say, we've tried it your way, guys. We tried to play your way, we tried to practice your way, we tried to be kind of loose with how we, our expectations and our standards, and we are in last place. Mm-hmm. It's not working, so guess what? Your way's out the window. And when it's Craig Berube saying that to you, it's harder to just, I don't know if I'm going to follow exactly what,
it's a little intimidating, first of all.
He is an intimidating guy, absolutely. Yeah. So I think he came in with the force of character and the strength in his voice to demand the respect and attention of his team because they were a good team. He got them to play his style, defensive, hard-nosed, physical. He got the arrival of Jordan Binnington, which obviously makes every coach look good when you have a good goaltender.
No,
you put all that together, and they went on a great run and won the Stanley Cup. But not every coach, despite being proficient in X's and O's, could have walked into that room in that moment and gotten the same reaction.
Situation.
Yeah. Even if they asked for the same things, it was because it was him that it worked.
And second go-around as a head coach, so he wasn't walking into something he didn't understand. He knew some of the players from his experience with the minor league team, so he knew some of the younger guys. And give some credit to the coaching staff as well that was with him. We saw Steve Ott in some of those.
Mike Van Ryan.
Some of the videos. Mike Van Ryan, Larry Robinson upstairs, and that group around him helped him a lot. And I wanted to give a shout-out also to Richie Matthews, who's the equipment guy there. Something unique, Richie has 3 Stanley Cups with 3 different teams. He was part of the Devils staff. He was part of the staff, obviously, now in St. Louis. And I'm missing the other one he's with. So, but he has 3.
But 3.
Dallas, New Jersey.
Because there's so many you can't remember.
Dallas,
all.
New Jersey.
3 more than me, so out of boy.
So, Richie Matthews, you're the man, the equipment man in St. Louis.
Great
guy.
Someone go hire him. You want him in a cup, go grab him.
Great guy.